Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Govinsky's Tutorials. So thanks to Dan7ape for pointing out that this great little free app got released just now and is available for Mac OS 11 or later, and iPad, iPhone, etc. iOS 14 or later, Apple Vision as well. Developer, a guy called Jan Maes. Now, it says, remake as AUv3 plugin of Mike Moreno's Bloop machine. So, if you go to this guy Mike Moreno's YouTube, you can also download the pure data version of this, or pure data, whatever way you pronounce it. So this is completely free, and it's really fun. It's really kind of instant Aphex. But there are a few little things that maybe could be improved or need fixing. But let's have a little listen to it first. So you can do a lot with just the step and mutate knobs. Endless hours of fun. But one problem I'll point out, and this is something that I really hope gets added, well, this does not seem, from what I can see, to have any way to be controlled by host transport. So here I've got it loaded inside AUM on my iPad, and you know, playing, pausing, rewinding and so on, and also the BPM in the host transport. Don't do anything to change the tempo of this, stop it, start it, and so on. So you have to use this knob to control tempo. So that is one thing that is genuinely problematic, because if you want to get this working with, let's say, a looper that uses host sync, you're not going to be able to. So if you wanted to use it with a looper, you're going to have to just, you know, do them the old-fashioned way. Which is fine, yeah, but it's not ideal, and you're going to have problems getting this to play along with other sequenced instruments. So, like, honestly, it really, really, I won't say need, but it would really, really benefit from having some kind of sync mode. I mean, there's no manual or anything like that. It looks like a completely straightforward app. I don't see any kind of switch to you know, control that. Yeah, I turned it off. I thought that maybe that'll work. No, it doesn't. So that's one thing. And another thing is MIDI Learn. You press MIDI Learn, it opens this up. Very strange, because it just looks like there's nothing there. But then you tap on these and you can see what they are. Like, this one is for tempo. This is for steps. And then, you know, you have this little Learn thing here. Thing is, like this, it only appears like this as long as you're pressing on it. Like, I press and it appears. I press again, it disappears. Or sorry, I unpress and it disappears. I can't see any way to actually, like, press the MIDI Learn button. And when I connected my MIDI controller, I just couldn't get it working. So if you see here, I have this SMC mixer connected, and I try and, you know, I press Learn or whatever, and, you know, twiddle the knob that I want to assign, but it just doesn't work. And I checked if the AUv3 parameters are exposed, so that's another way that we could assign, you know, external MIDI controller knobs to it. So click on this in AUM you know, whatever host you're using will have its own ways. Click on global, and I already actually assigned mutate, but let's just try again. So learning, and now I'm twiddling a knob. Let me twiddle a different knob. Okay, so you see that's changed to 31. But it's just not working. I'm twiddling that knob now and nothing's happening. Even though here it says it's assigned, it's just not. So the MIDI learn and stuff is broken in this. So that definitely needs to be fixed, or maybe it's something with my device, but I don't know, I just can't get it working. Let's try another preset. So tempo, steps, mutate. Cut off. A really nice kind of old school sounding reverb lo-fi. Sample rate. Let's try this on the chiptune one. Nice, huh? Bit rate. And this will take you to the website of the app developer. Ah, got another, got a couple of things actually for iOS. So yeah, brilliant. Just really, really would like transport sync and for the MIDI learn to be working for me. So please smash the like, everyone, if you enjoyed this video. I put up a couple of videos in the past day or two that still have giveaways open at the time of putting this video up. This one, the giveaway will be finished very soon. Audio Things SR88, which just came out for iOS. It's been out for on desktop for years. And then this really nice Astrometry X, a small version of the Astrometry delay for desktop. And yeah, I made a video on that yesterday. Really enjoying that. Beautiful. So go and check those out if you haven't. And yeah, try your luck entering the giveaway. Remember, everybody, please, if you're a fan of this channel and you want me to be able to keep doing this, I really, really need support on Patreon. And you get a lot back. So go and check out my Patreon. Gavinsky's tutorials, just I'll put a link in the description, but if you just Google Gavinsky Patreon, you'll find it. All right, everyone, thank you for watching. Please smash the like and write a comment to help the algorithm if you can, and I'll see you in the next video.